Hello, and welcome to The New Creationist. I'm Eugene. Today, I'll be showing you how to use the Ensembl Genome Browser to run genetic comparisons between different species. To get to the Ensembl website, you can simply type in the URL, or enter Ensembl Genome Browser into the search bar and follow the link. Please notice there's no E at the end of Ensembl. We'll be using the most recent version, which is release 71 as of April 2013. Ensembl release 71, April 2013. Once you get to the site, you can bookmark it if you like. All right, we're gonna begin by clicking on the human genome as a starting point. Now, from here, we can enter something into the search bar here, or you can click on one of the items below, which are just examples of what you could enter. You could put in a gene. if you happen to have a gene that you know you're looking for, CIC or IF4, FOXP2, or whatever. You can also put in chromosome location, like chromosome 1, location 1 through 100,000, or something like that. You could put in a condition like coronary heart disease, or diabetes, glaucoma, you know, just whatever, so forth. For the purpose of this video, we're just going to click on what's here as an example, osteoarthritis. And that's going to give us a list of the genes associated with this particular condition. You could also look for the phenotype and variation. Since we're actually here to do gene comparisons and we need to pick a gene to do a comparison across genomes, we're just going to click on gene. Since we're already on the human section, we're going to click on human. And that's going to give you the list of genes, in this case, 6 genes associated with osteoarthritis. And we're just going to click on the first one, which is matrilin 3. It's going to take a second here to load. And here we go. So now we're on the gene summary page for matrilin 3, which is a gene on chromosome 2 at location 20,191,872 through 20,212,455. And it's going to give you a list of the transcripts here. This gene has 3 transcripts, and what we're going to do is we're going to look at the orthologs. Basically, what an ortholog is, when they identify the same gene in different species, and it could have a varying degree of similarity or homology, same things. Homology is similarity, so that when you compare the genes and it's like 90% similar or 99% similar in another species, or even less, you know, it could be less than 75%. We have the percent of similarity is automatically set at 50% for most of the orthologs you're going to look at. Some of them are going to be lower, but it's not going to show up if it's going to say no orthologs, like we're looking at primates here. And we can click this box, but so far we have a one-to-one for all of the 10 primates, which is we're looking at. We're in human now, so we're looking at the other 9 primates, because there's 10 primates listed in the Ensembl website. So now, after checking the box for primates, we're going to scroll down and look at the list. In order, we're looking at the query percent ID as compared to human. So human is the query, and the percent ID of human to chimpanzee is 99%. Gibbon is 97%. Orangutan also 97%. Marmoset is 92%, macaque 88, bush baby 88, gorilla 84, tarsier 84, and mouse lemur is 60% similar to human by the query percent. Now, if we were going to go and look at that 99% similar to chimpanzee, of that 99%, 99% of it is similar. In other words, the target is chimpanzee, so that the query is human. So when we're comparing the human to chimp, you get 99%, gibbon 97. Of that 97, 96% is identical to at a gibbon to is identical to human. If you went all the way down here, mouse lemur 60% similar to human. Of that 60%, 70% is identical. So one way to do that is we're going to look at the protein alignment, which is the easiest way to do it, because the codons, there's going to be one-third as many codons or amino acids as there are base pairs. So the nucleotide base pairs in this case, for the longest transcript in human, is 2,524 base pairs long, but the amino acid length is only 486. So when we're comparing that to Microcebus murinus, which is the mouse lemur, you see the percent of identity from human to mouse lemur is 60%, and that's because, or in other words, so we got 486 amino acids in human, there's only 416 amino acids in the mouse lemur. So of that 416 amino acids, 70% show identity with human, which is how we know it's this particular gene. That's how we identify the gene in this species. Now, one thing, and then of course down here you're going to have the sequence. The top sequence here is for human, and these are the amino acids, the amino acid sequence for the protein, and the one below it, the line below it, is for mouse lemur. So here you've got human. Right, now let me just highlight that for you. Oh, if I can do that. So that is for human, and that is for mouse lemur. And of course, the dashes means that there's no this part of the protein chain is not in mouse lemur. So hence the percent of similarity at 60% of what is in mouse lemur and human together, which is going to be indicated by the asterisks below the sequence as it's lined up here, 70% is going to be identical. So you're going to go through and you see, like, these dots mean there's a substitution. For example, in human you have a different amino acid than you have in mouse lemur. And the asterisk, of course, means that it's the same, R and R. Okay, now, and down here, again, you have another stretch where you have part of the amino acid sequence is in human, but it's not in mouse lemur. Okay, and now let's skip backwards. So we're going to go look now at, that was one primate. There's 10 primates. So it's human plus 9 more, which is 10. But we're going to unclick this box and look at everything. So just go down the list. We got first up, most similar to human is chimpanzee. Next, gibbon, orangutan, marmoset, and cow. after that, macaque. Now, of course, we're noticing, you're immediately going to notice when you start doing some of these comparisons that where you would expect primates to group together, and a lot of times they do, but usually not in the same order. But you're going to find different animals kind of creep into the primate node. And the reason for that, of course, is because common ancestry doesn't work. Because if all the primates had a common ancestor more recently, than a supposed common ancestor between human and cows, then the primate should be more similar to human than a cow would be to human. So here is evidence. Here the evidence begins to pile up against common ancestry. Of course, you could go look at the protein alignment. You could also look at the cDNA alignment. Which is actually what's going to code for that protein. And you could look at the gene tree, but the gene tree function, they've changed that so many times that sometimes I look at it just to see what they have in their latest version. But I found it to be ever-changing, and so sometimes I don't even look at it. Sometimes just for entertainment's sake, but anyway. Then macaque, which is a primate. Bush baby is a primate. Squirrel. Of course, squirrel is not a primate. At 86% similarity to human. Pig, again, not a primate. Dog, 85%. Gorilla at 84%. Now, and you're going to notice that of that 84%, 99% is identical to human. However, 84% is still lower than a dog or a pig. Oh, wait. Yes. And squirrel. So the question is going to be, of course, why is gorilla less similar than there's tarsier, which is another 84%. You know, right up there with Megabat. Although you want to see, you know, okay, well, Megabat, of that 84%, 85% is identical. Well, that, I'm not sure that's helping a lot, but as far as the case for evolution, mouse at 83%, microbat 83%, ferret 82%, kangaroo rat 81%, And you kind of see where my point is going here, because when we get to mouse lemur, which was 60%, it's still way lower as a primate than rat, pika, horse, alpaca. Panda is 76%, and we're going to go down quite a ways here before we get to the mouse lemur. We're going to go right past rabbit, tree shrew, guinea pig, hyrax. We see alpaca again. Oh, so what we've done now, alpaca has more than one copy of this gene, looks like. So we could go back, you could go back and look for that if you like, because alpaca was right here, one to many. And so alpaca's got more than one copy of that. Where you see one to one, panda has one copy that we know of, anyhow, has one copy of that gene. All right, and let's keep on looking. Guinea pig, hyrax, alpaca. Okay, back to where we were. Armadillo at 71%. Dolphin at 70%. Shrew at 65%. Hedgehog at 64%. Tasmanian devil at 63%. And mouse lemur. Okay, so now this is a primate. At 60% similarity for the matrilin 3 gene. As compared to human. So the question, of course, here then, as you're looking at the data, is how is it then that people are asserting that, like, the nested hierarchy, as far as evidence for evolution, really the evidence for evolution is falling apart when you begin looking at the data. Here we've just looked at the first gene. You can look at gene after gene and you begin to see that pretty much the evidence is way stacked, is totally stacked against common descent. Common ancestry is just unraveling. So what I'm showing you here is just the method by which you can go through. This is the first gene. You can go through and check for any. If you wanted to look, let's say, coronary heart disease. Or you could do the next gene on the list. There was a list we had going on. I lost track of the list. All right, well, let's go back to coronary heart disease. Okay, right here, and look at the gene. There's 7 genes associated with this particular condition that we clicked on. We're going to click on this, MMP3, matrix, metallopeptidase 3. We're going to click on that. And so that's going to pull the MMP3 gene up here in just a second. And let's go check the ortholog list real quick. And scroll down. Now for this one, you're going to have 7 primates that have a 1-to-1 ratio, or 1-to-1 ortholog, and no orthologs are according to this particular search. Now we'd have to go back and verify this data to make sure that this isn't a mistake or a glitch. And we would do that by using the BLAST. We can also use the comparative genomics and genomic alignments to look for the missing primates, the two missing primates here, you could actually click on this and go down the list of 10 primates. While we're already looking from the human genome, so you're looking for 9 more primates, so you could go down and check which ones are here to find the one that's not, or that the two in this case that aren't here. So you got chimp, gorilla, gibbon, orangutan, macaque, marmoset, tarsier. So what's missing is mouse lemur and bush baby. Okay, so we're missing mouse lemur and bush. Mouse lemur and bush baby, right? So the question then, of course, would be, why aren't they here? They're primates. They should be here, but they're not. And of course, you know, like I said, we'd have to go and verify to make sure that, you know, maybe the gene is in bush baby or mouse lemur, but it just didn't, for some reason, it didn't show up in the search. Sometimes that happens, actually, because sometimes, if you'll notice, some of these are not normal genomic locations. Like this is chromosome 11 with a particular nucleotide position, and some of these aren't. Like this is a gene scaffold, which means it could be that the mouse lemur and bush baby, being low coverage genomes, in other words, they haven't been looked at enough and processed a lot, so some things might kind of slip through the cracks, so to speak. And you know, we'd have to go back and look and make sure that's not the case, because it could be the gene is there, it just hasn't been it kind of missed that we kind of missed it somewhere, which is possible. So we have to allow for error in that case. But we're going to uncheck the box and look for the sequences that we do have, momentarily just ignoring those two species. And we're going to look at the, in this case, you've got chimpanzee at 99, gorilla at 98, gibbon, orangutan, macaque. So this is actually starting to look pretty much the way it should look, if evolutionary common descent were actually the case. Marmoset at 90%, tarsier 86, squirrel 84, rabbit at 84. Okay, so I think we already have something missing here, because squirrel, rabbit, cat, obviously they're not primates. So let's take one, let's see, squirrel at 84, and now we're going to go back and see, click the box, squirrel at 84. Okay, so that pretty much looks like it should look roughly. I'm not sure that they'd be in the same order as what the phylogenetic trees that are supported by evolutionary biologists should look like, you know. And the chimp and gorilla, that sounds about right, but next should be orangutan instead of gibbon, so it's out of order, because orangutan should be up here. Okay, but that's like maybe a minor discrepancy that evolutionary biologists might be able to explain away or just shrug at. Minor discrepancy. Of course, this would be a major discrepancy. Two primates without the gene at all. So if upon verifying this, we actually found that yes, this gene does not appear in bush baby or or the other one, mouse lemur, then we'd have a problem. And I do believe this probably is a problem because there's so many problems. And all right, there's other ways of going about this. If you wanted to click on the location, this will take us to the location here on chromosome 6 for human. So here's another way you could pick out genes to run comparisons on, is by simply going to a particular chromosome. Like you could click here on the MOXD1 gene here and click on that, or you could have clicked on the chromosome location here, and it'll take a second to get there. Here's the MOXD1 gene. You could do the same thing, go to OrthLogs, and there it's gonna do the same thing, scroll down, and then you can get to the OrthLog screen here, and then go down and click query percent, chimpanzee 100%, and then just go down and do your comparisons. When you do that, like we already looked through the protein alignment for the first gene, you could also do the cDNA alignment, which in this case is a fairly long gene, so it nearly at about 3,000 base pairs long, so you're going to have a lot of stuff to look through here, which is usually why I just look first at the protein. All right, well, so far that's a pretty good start. So you can pick out genes that way. Once you get a list, maybe a list of genes you want to look at, or if you're reading a paper and somebody's talking about a specific gene, you can come here and look it up. You could put it here in the search bar here, or from the human genome here, or from the very first page, you could put it here. And search all species, or you could pick one, any particular one. And of course, human is usually where I start because that's where I want my query to start. All right, that's a lot. That's enough for today, and hopefully this video is not too long. But until next time, God bless.